Esports Barangay Ginebra crushes visiting Bay Area Dragons to secure the 2022 PBA Commissioner's Cup Championship. The Gin Kings fired on all cylinders in a stunning 114-99 victory over the Dragons in the deciding game of the best of seven series. It was a special victory for the Kings as they did it in front of a record-breaking crowd of over 54,000 fans at the Philippine Arena in Bulacan.
The death toll from widespread flooding across the Philippines has climbed to 27. That's according to the Office of Civil Defense. The agency also says more than 614,000 people have been affected by the series of low-pressure areas and the shear line since January 2. Many flood-ravaged areas have declared a state of calamity, while local executives appeal for additional relief goods. The Social Welfare Department says it has so far distributed 88 million pesos worth of assistance to communities affected by flash floods. The agency on Saturday said it has over 1 billion pesos worth of available stockpiles and quick response fund ready for distribution. Let's get an update on the weather now with State Bureau Weather Pag-asa. Joining us on the line is forecaster Rhea Torres. Rhea, good morning. What do you have for us?
Yes, good morning to you as well, Ms. Nikki, as well as to our viewers. As of the moment, we are monitoring a low-pressure area, and as of 3 a.m. this morning, it was estimated based on all available data at 180 kilometers east of Butuan City, Agusan del Norte. It still has a low chance into developing a tropical depression within the next 24 hours. However, the combined effects of this low-pressure area as well as shear line would be bringing cloudy skies with scattered rain showers and thunderstorms over Manila, Bicol Region, Mimaropa, and Calabarzon. Meanwhile, northeast monsoon will be affecting extreme northern Luzon and will be bringing cloudy skies with rains over Batanes, Cagayan, and Apayao. Meanwhile, Ilocos Region, the rest of Cordillera, and the rest of Cagayan Valley will be experiencing generally fair weather conditions besides chances of light rains. And for the rest of the country, partly cloudy to cloudy skies with isolated rain showers or thunderstorms due to localized thunderstorms. And for the following days, the northeast monsoon will be continuing to prevail over large portions of Luzon. Meanwhile, here in southern Luzon area will most likely be experiencing rainy days for the following days due to the effects of shear line. Meanwhile, for Visayas and Mindanao, expect fair weather conditions besides the occasional isolated rain showers and thunderstorms brought about by localized thunderstorms. And as of the moment, we still have a gale warning raised over the seaboards of northern Luzon and eastern seaboard of central Luzon. Therefore, fishing boats and other small sea craft are still advised not to venture out into sea, while larger sea vessels are alerted against big waves. Temperatures in Metro Manila will be ranging from 24 to 31 degrees Celsius, here in Baguio City 15 to 24, Legazpi City 24 to 29, Metro Cebu 25 to 29, and for Metro Davao 26 to 31 degrees Celsius. And that's the latest here from Pag-asa Weather Forecasting Center. This is Rhea Torres reporting.
And Rhea, just very quickly, how long do you think we'll be experiencing the cold weather this year in Metro Manila?
Yes, here in Metro Manila, since we're expecting a surge of northeast monsoon winds that will be most likely be experienced starting today, here for the next few days until this coming weekend, we might experience cold weather here, especially in the Luzon area.
All right. Thanks for joining us this morning, Rhea Yusuzi. Meanwhile, the Calapan Port and Oriental Mindoro will soon open the biggest port passenger terminal in the country. The Philippine Ports Authority General Manager Jay Santiago says the project, which costs 353 million pesos, is expected to be completed on February 18 this year and open to the public by March. Santiago notes this facility will be able to handle more passengers, not only from Oriental Mindoro, but from neighboring provinces as well. The terminal can reportedly accommodate 3,500 passengers at any given time.